Microsoft has finally responded to all the rumors about Xbox Live Gold potentially going free or changing in the near future. There's a lot here to talk about, so let's get into it. What is going on, everybody? It's Randall419, the man with the million, back again with another video. For everyone's having a great day. If you guys could do me a big favor, make sure you hit that like, subscribe, and share button. It means a lot. Thank you guys for all the support. So I feel like I have to start from the beginning with this story. A couple weeks ago, people noticed that Microsoft had removed the yearly $60 subscription for Xbox Live Gold, making people wonder if Microsoft was changing the service somehow. Then you had insiders like Jeff Grubb of VentureBeat basically come out and speculate that Xbox Live Gold was going away and that the multiplayer paywall was going to be completely gone. And then you had the announcement of Halo Infinite actually being free to play everywhere on Xbox consoles and the PC. But it wouldn't be truly free to play on Xbox consoles, as Microsoft requires Xbox Live Gold for free-to-play games. Yes, that's right. They're the only console manufacturer that puts the free-to-play games behind a paywall. PlayStation and Nintendo don't do that. So this whole change prompted me to make a speculation video about what Microsoft could be doing with Xbox Live Gold. Could they be folding it into Game Pass? Could they be getting rid of Gold completely? Or maybe it was just a free-to-play paywall that would go away. And then yesterday, people noticed that Microsoft changed the terms of service. And it said that in the Xbox section and throughout the terms, we've updated the Xbox heading, changed Xbox Live to refer to Xbox Online Service, and refer to Xbox consoles rather than Xbox One and Xbox 360 consoles. We've updated Xbox services to include the Xbox Online Service, Xbox Game Studio games, including Mojang games, applications, subscriptions, services, and content provided by Microsoft. This, of course, fueled more speculation and rumor. Why would Microsoft be getting rid of Xbox Live and their terms and services and replacing it with Xbox Online Service? People were sure that announcement would be coming pretty soon, that Microsoft was changing Xbox Live Gold in some way and hopefully making it free. The dream was that Microsoft would remove the paywall for every single game so that you could play Fortnite without a subscription, that you could play the newest Call of Duty without a subscription, and people were really warming up to the idea of Microsoft getting rid of it, even though right now it may not make the most financial sense, as Microsoft makes a ton of money from Xbox Live Gold revenue. While that dream might be dead for now, at least, as Microsoft has responded to the rumors and gave a quote to Windows Central that said, "The update to Xbox Online Service in the Microsoft Services Agreement refers to the underlying Xbox service that includes features like cross saves and friend requests. This language update is intended to distinguish that underlying service and the paid Xbox Load subscription. There are no changes being made to the experience of the service or Xbox Live Gold." It seems pretty cut and dry right there. Microsoft saying, hey, it's normal business, we're updating our terms of service, it refers to these things, and that we aren't changing Xbox Live Gold right now. But then Tom Warren tweeted out something interesting. He says, "Microsoft tells me it's not renaming Xbox Live or discontinuing Xbox Live Gold. Quote, we have no plans to discontinue Xbox Live Gold at this time, a spokesperson says. That doesn't mean Xbox Live won't go free," details in his article. Now, the statement, "we have no plans to discontinue Xbox Live Gold at this time," is an interesting one. If Microsoft had no plans of discontinuing it at any point in time, they would just say, "we have no plans to discontinue Xbox Live Gold." But the "at this time" means that in a month from now, in a year from now, they could do that and the statement would hold true. So I do think something is going on. And I don't think Xbox Live Gold would be going free or going away. I think what's going to happen in the near term, maybe at the end of this month, maybe next month, is that Microsoft will announce that the free-to-play games, like Halo Infinite, Fortnite, Warzone for Call of Duty, those will be free to play without the need of Xbox Live Gold, drawing parity to PlayStation and Nintendo. So I 100% think the free to play paywall is going down. And I do think eventually, not tomorrow, not next month, maybe not even this year, maybe not even in 2021, but at some point in time, Microsoft is going to remove the paywall for everything. But they're not at that point yet. When I think they drop the paywall is when Xbox Game Pass reaches a certain internal milestone. Maybe when Game Pass has more subscribers than Xbox Live Gold and they can drop it and make it a huge feature about why you should play in the Xbox ecosystem, but they're not at this point yet. We know they have over 10 million subscribers for Game Pass, and we assume that Xbox Live Gold has probably around 22 million, maybe 25 million, as historically the number of Gold members was always about half of the Xbox console user base. However, there's a big white elephant in the room that Microsoft needs to address really soon, and that is the removal of the 12-month option for getting Xbox Live Gold and multiplayer for $60 a year. That has completely gone from their website. Sure, you can head over to Amazon and Best Buy and buy 12-month cards, but Microsoft is no longer offering it themselves. And this would essentially mean if you needed gold, you would either have to get it through Game Pass Ultimate, which is $15 a month, or $10 for the 1 month, or $25 for 3 months, making gold essentially $100 a year or $120 a year, depending on how you go about it, instead of the $60 you would normally get in a 12-month subscription, making gold more expensive. And bad PR isn't something Microsoft can really afford right now. The Xbox Game Showcase, which was a couple weeks ago, people weren't too hot on. But when you talk about PlayStation Now and Xbox Live Gold, the prices were always similar, $60 to $60 for the same sort of features. But now if Xbox is removing that $60 12-month subscription and it's either $100 or $120, and you're offering maybe the same online service but significantly worse games than your competitor, Sony would have an absolute field day saying that, hey, come over to us and you can play the newest Call of Duty online for half the price as our competitor, basically. That would be absolutely horrible. And if I'm being quite honest with all my listeners right now, there's nothing that Xbox has done with Xbox Live this year that would justify the price increase whatsoever. We know that Microsoft has a bunch of news planned for August. We already saw that Microsoft announced the xCloud launch date, which I said would happen in my August video, so who knows what Microsoft's timetable is for changing or removing anything about Xbox Live. My personal prediction is that the free-to-play will be announced and it will be gone before Halo Infinite launches on the Series X, because you don't want to have a conversation where it's free-to-play on the PC and it is not free-to-play on Xbox because you need that gold subscription. That would end very badly. So anyways, guys, that's the video. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button, share this out on social media, or tell a friend about the channel. If you always want to be notified when I drop new videos, hit the notification bell. And if you want to go even further and support the channel, make sure you hit the join button. We got some new channel badges and some emojis for the Xbox 2 podcast. Anyways, thanks for watching the video, guys. I truly appreciate it, and I'll see everybody in the next one. Later, guys.